Okay, in the previous class, we gone through of problems based on a periodic and non-periodic signal. When a equation is given, how to check whether a signal is periodic or not by using of the equation for a continuous and also for the discrete time we gone through. And also when a set of a signal which is consisting of two or three more signals with the different periods. From that, when we add all the signals, how we can determine whether the signal is a continuous or else a periodic or non-periodic. Okay, we come across these problems. Next, we'll go with the next type of problems. In the previous their problems, what we solved, they only given for us what is the period of the periodic signal. But in the next problems, they are giving the equation. From that equation, we have to find the periodicity. Then we have to tell, after adding or multiplying of those, we have to tell whether the signal is going to be a periodic or a non-periodic. We'll start with the next problem. Here, determine whether the discrete time signal is periodic of the signal. That is, x of n is equals to cos 1 by 5 pi n into sin 1 by 3 pi n. Here a equation is given for us. From this equation we have to tell whether this signal is a periodic or not. This is our given signal. Next, use the equation, that is sin a cos b, that is 1 by 2 sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. This is a standard equation. Here sin a is going to be 1 by 3 pi n, then cos b is going to be, the b is going to be 1 by 5 pi n. If I substitute in the equation, what I will be getting, x of n is going to be 1 by 2 sin a is pi by 3 plus b is pi by 5. I take an n outside, common factor, that is n, plus sin a is pi by 3 minus b is pi by 5 n. If I solve for this, I'll be getting as sin 8 pi by 15 n plus sin 2 pi by 15 n. This is you'll be getting. Yes. Ah, no, I didn't hear. Yeah. Sorry. This is the next problem. Okay, here a x of n signal is given. We have to check whether the signal is periodic or not. Okay, x of n is cos 1 by 5 pi n sin 1 by 3 pi n. X of n, the given signal is of this. Here we are going to use the equation, that is sin a cos b, that is going to be 1 by 2 sin a plus b plus a sin a minus b. A is our, in this based on this equation, a is going to be 1 by 3 pi n and b is going to be 1 by 5 pi n. I'm substituting in the equation, so I'll be getting as 1 by 2 sin pi by 3 n pi by 3 plus pi by 5 n. I'm taking n as a common. Okay, plus sin pi by 3 minus a minus b, for that reason pi by 3 minus pi by 5 into n. If you solve here, you'll be getting as 1 by 2 sin 8 pi by 15 n plus sin 2 pi by 15 into n. This you will be getting off. Then first I will find what is the angular frequency of the first parameter of this. Remember, directly you should not take when it is a multiplication. When you are going to take the equation in terms of a summation, then find the angular frequency. Okay, this small point you have to remember when it is given in terms of a equation. Okay, angular frequency of sin 8 pi by 15 n is going to be taken as omega 1 is going to be 8 pi by 15. This in terms of rational multiply of 2 pi we have to take. For that reason, from this I taken 2 pi taken outside. Then what I will be getting here, 4 by 15 I will be remaining. If I multiply, I will be taking the same. From this, what is the period is going to be taken? This is 2 pi m divided by capital N. this is a standard formula. So I can write here as m is going to be 4 and n1 is going to be 15. Okay, in the same way you go for the next two, that is sine 2 pi by 15 n. Formula first, the fundamental period n1 is going to be 15. In the same way you go for the second term, so you will be getting as omega 2 pi by 15. This is 2 pi by 15. So in this, how I can write in terms of a 2 pi into rational number, this is 2 pi. So what is the left thing here? 1 divided by 15. Okay, then from this, what is our m is going to be 1 and n2 is going to be 15. Then fundamental period is going to be n2 is going to be 15. Then what you have to do, we have to take the ratio of t1 divided by ti, right? Here in the discrete time, it's going to be n1 divided by n2, because only two periods are given here for that reason. n1 by n2 is going to be 15 by 15, that is 1 by 1. Then LCM of the denominator is going to be taken as L, that is going to be 1, because the GCD is going to be 1 only for that reason. No need of finding the GCD again, okay? Directly go for the finding the LCM here. Then therefore the period of x of n, that is capital N, is going to be n1 into L. n1 is 15 and L is 1. 15 into 1, you will be getting as 15 only. This is how you have to solve the problem when it is given in terms of a equation way. Okay, then the next problem, find the periodicity of the signal x of n, that is cos 2 pi n divided by 5 plus cos 2 pi n divided by 7. It is directly given, it is in terms of a summation only. So no need of using any formula here. Directly you go with the finding the angular frequency. From the angular frequency, find out your fundamental period. Okay, this is for the first parameter, for the first term. What is the angular frequency of this? It's going to be taken as omega 1 is equals to 2 pi. It is in a standard form only, 2 pi into 1 by 5 I can write. So fundamental period is going to be n1 is going to be 5. And if we go for the second term, here angular frequency of cos 2 pi n divided by 7 is omega 2 is going to be 2 pi into 1 by 7. Then fundamental period is n2 is going to be 7. Therefore n1 by n2 is going to be 5 by 7. This is in a rational way. So hence x of n is going to be a periodic. What is the GCD of 7? It's going to be 1. So n1 by n2 I can write as 5 divided by 7 into 1. What is the LCM of here? Of the denominator, L is going to be 7. Therefore fundamental period capital N is going to be n1 into L. n1 is nothing but 5. 5 into 7, L is 7 here. So if you multiply, you will be getting as 35. This is the fundamental period of the given signal, that is x of n signal. Okay, these two are different types of problems. You may expect different values here. Don't think the same values will be given in the exam. Okay, these are all different types of problems based on periodic and non-periodic signal.